And we are here now with John Ridley, the Oscar-winning writer behind 12 Years a Slave. Well, he is back with a new documentary called Let It Fall. It's about the L.A. riots 25 years ago when the police officers who beat Rodney King were acquitted. And in this clip, one man talked about watching the riots on TV and running out to help. Let's take a look.
I said, Bobby, where you going? I said, I'm going to save that man's life. He told you that. I said, I think God told me, Mama. God told me 3 or 4 times to go save him. I was on a mission. I don't know why God picked me, but he chose me. Out of 1 million people, he chose me.
Mm. And usually when, and thank you, John, thank you for joining me, first
Absolutely.
Of all. And usually when you see something like this, it's told from the side of a historian or a talking head, but you approached it a different way. You wanted to hear from the real people who were there and involved.
Yeah, we have about 25 different individuals. The story begins, it just seems like it's a collection of people talking about their families, mm-hmm. their circumstances, their backgrounds. But what we begin to understand is that almost every individual that we hear from was intimately involved in an event that led to this uprising. We start in 1982, we go to 1992. It's a story of perspectives, of people, of communities, and a person like that, Bobby Green, who just saw what was going on and said, that's enough. I see someone, he doesn't look like me, but I've got to go out and I've got to do something. I have to help. It was a very important story to tell.
And we know all the, a lot of the images that we've seen. There was a lot of the, you know, fires and yeah. violence and things of that nature. But it was very important for you to show the kindness of it all as well.
It's a very heartbreaking event. I think if people know anything about it, they know that there was a lot of distress. There was a lot of friction among communities. We knew that we were going to break hearts, but we also wanted to lift spirits and show people that if we give ourselves over to our better nature, we can do better.
And you had just moved to L.A. not long before this happened. So how personal is this story to you?
It was very personal. I moved from New York where I come from a small town in the Midwest where mm-hmm. my circumstances were different, tended to get along with people. Part of that was just a matter of demographics. Came to New York. There were a lot more problems, racial problems here than I was aware of. Went to Los Angeles. At that mm-hmm. time, it was the dream city, the L.A. of 1984, the Olympics. That's what I remembered. So to be in a space where you realize you can't just move away from issues. You have to find spaces and create a better space. Mm-hmm. That's what I learned, and I think that's what I take with me today.
And you're known for these hard-hitting, intense projects. But you're a father. You have 2 kids.
Yeah.
They're kind of like, Dad, make an Iron Man. Make something like that.
One of my sons said to me the other day, and he's 13, he said to me, Dad, you know what? You have to start thinking about switching up genres. So that's something only kids in Los Angeles say, talking about changing genres.
But, you know, there's been a lot of media coverage about this, but I think there's something we're all going to learn new from what you're putting out there right now. And I got to say, you make some of the most riveting projects. You put out the most riveting projects that I think everyone needs to see and everyone's learning from. And I want to thank you for that.
Absolutely.
Really admirable.
Thank you, sir.
Putting together for a long time.
Continue to do it.
Tell your son, they'll get what they want eventually. But right now, you're doing great work, and we appreciate you for that. And John's, it's called Let It Fall. It's in theaters now. It airs tonight at 9 and 8 Central on ABC. Don't you miss Let It Fall, everybody.